The German army introduced the Tiger I tank in 1942, which sent the Allied forces into a frenzy. The need to overcome the German armor was becoming more apparent to the British Army, and led to the development of new radical vehicles. The British 17-pounder anti-tank gun outperformed all other Allied armor-piercing guns, and was quickly adapted for use on various tank chassis. Due to delays and difficulties with the entirely new designs of the cruiser Mark 8 Challenger and Cromwell, the British government were open to the idea of modifying an existing tank. The British Army used Sherman tanks extensively during the war. Though they anticipated the development of their own tank models shortly, the 17-pounder installation in the Sherman was eventually accepted, despite initial government opposition. The nickname Firefly was adopted, due to the bright muzzle flash of the main gun. After solving the challenging problem of fitting such a large gun in the Sherman's turret, the Firefly was put into production in early 1944, in time to equip Field Marshal Bernard Montgomery's 21st Army Group for the Normandy landings. The 17-pounder, designed as a successor for the British quick-firing 6-pounder, was the most powerful British tank gun of the war, and one of the most powerful of any country, capable of penetrating more armor than the 88mm KWK-36 on the German Tiger I. The 17-pounder was a formidable weapon, that it gave the Firefly a real punch on the battlefield. Using standard APC-BC ammunition, the Firefly 17-pounder could theoretically penetrate 163mm of armor at 500 meters, and 150mm at 1000 meters. APDS ammunition could penetrate about 233mm at 1000 meters, which could theoretically defeat the armor of almost every German armored fighting vehicle, at any conceivable range. War production APDS rounds, on the other hand, lacked accuracy, and the 50mm penetrator was less destructive after penetrating enemy tank armor than the 76.2mm APC-BC shell. Also, APDS ammunition was rare until after the war. Despite its greater anti-tank capabilities, the 17-pounder lacked an effective HE round, and was therefore inferior to the standard Sherman 75mm gun, against soft targets such as infantry, buildings, and lightly armored vehicles. The Firefly's production began in January 1944, and by the May 31, 1944, 342 Sherman Fireflies had been delivered to the 21st Army Group for the D-Day landings. The timing was fortunate, since Allied intelligence had started to realize in early 1944, that the Germans were fielding a lot more powerful tanks, such as the Panther, than had been anticipated. This information was slow to reach Allied military planners, who had mistakenly assumed the Panther, like the Tiger, would be a rare heavy tank with a limited production run. As a result, the number of Panthers deployed came as a surprise to Allied formation commanders and tank crews. Only around 500 of the 2,300 German tanks deployed in Normandy were Panthers and Tigers, with the rest being Panzer IVs, Sturmgeschütz tank destroyers and other armored vehicles that the 75mm Shermans could penetrate. Because of the importance of Kahn and Montgomery's operations, which pinned German armored forces in front of British positions, allowing American units to break out to the west, British and other Commonwealth units had to face more than 70% of the German armor deployed during the Battle of Normandy, as well as more than half of the elite, well-equipped Waffen-SS Panzer units. As a result, the Sherman Firefly was possibly the most valuable tank in the hands of British and other Commonwealth commanders, as it was the only tank in the British Army capable of reliably penetrating the frontal armor of Panthers and Tigers at standard combat distances in Normandy. The Germans also noticed the new threat, and allegedly directed their tank crews to take out the Fireflies first, but this has never been verified by the German tank crews. Similarly, the Firefly crews realized that the new powerful weapon, which was easily identifiable due to its much longer barrel, would be targeted first, so they devised a brilliant method of hiding the Fireflies. Some crews had the front half of the olive drab gun barrel painted white on the bottom, or white with dark green on top, which served a form of dazzle camouflage, and gave the gun the appearance of being the length of a standard M4 Sherman. Given the great value put on Fireflies, it was typical for commanders to reconnoiter the battlefield before a battle, looking for good overwatch positions. During the battle, Fireflies would remain in those positions and cover the standard Shermans as they advanced, eliminating any enemy tanks that revealed themselves when they opened fire on the advancing Shermans, and going forward only when the standard Shermans had secured the area, or when the Fireflies could no longer cover them. Similarly, when on the move, troop commanders opted to put Fireflies in the rear, to decrease the possibility of them being knocked out. The Firefly's enhanced firepower was highly valued, and it proved its worth in numerous engagements, knocking out Tigers and Panthers at long range, as well as less fearsome tanks like Panzer IVs and Stug tank destroyers. Lieutenant G.K. Henry's Firefly demonstrated this increased firepower during the defense of Norrie en Bessin on the 9th of June 1944, against an attack by the 3rd Company of the 12th SS Panzer Regiment of the 12th SS Panzer Division. SS Commander Kurt Meyer ordered 12 Panthers of the 3rd Company and infantry to attack Norrie and drive out the Canadians, in preparation for a larger operation to drive the British and Canadians back into the sea. At 1300 hours, the Panthers launched an all-out assault on the town, stopping only to fire their guns. They swiftly outran their infantry support, who were forced to the ground by Allied artillery fire. 9 standard Shermans of the Canadian 1st Hussars opened fire on the advancing Panthers' flanks at about 1,000 meters. Trooper A. Chapman, Lieutenant Henry's gunner, waited until the Panthers lined up like ducks in a row, before quickly knocking out 5 Panthers with only 6 shots. The German attack was repulsed, with 7 of the 12 Panthers being destroyed. A similar event occurred on June 14, during Operation Perch. After taking the village of Lingevers, near Tilly-sur-Soles, Sergeant Harris of the 4th Dragoon Guards in his Firefly, along with 3 standard Shermans, established up defensive positions alongside the infantry. Sergeant Harris observed 2 Panthers approaching from the east through his binoculars. He opened fire at a distance of 800 meters, destroying the lead Panther with his first shot, and the other with his second. He moved to a well-hidden flanking position on the other side of the town, when he noticed 3 Panthers approaching from the west. He and his gunner knocked them out with 3 rounds. During Operation Totalize on August 8, 1944, British and Canadian Fireflies, in possibly their most famous operation, destroyed 5 Tiger tanks and killed the attack's leader, the renowned German tank commander Michael Wittmann. The battle involved Fireflies from A Squadron, 1st Northamptonshire Yeomanry, 33rd Armoured Brigade, A Squadron, Sherbrooke Fusiliers Regiment, 2nd Canadian Armoured Brigade, and B Squadron, the 144th Regiment Royal Armoured Corps, 33rd Armoured Brigade. They ambushed a group of 7 Tiger tanks, from the 3rd and HQ companies of the 101st SS Heavy Tank Battalion, who were supported by Panzer IV tanks and Stug IV assault guns, inflicting heavy casualties in the process. Shermans possessed the advantage of speed and mobility, allowing them to maneuver for position more easily than Tigers. Along with the Churchill, the Firefly was probably the most famous British tank of the Second World War. It could deal with German armor and, on paper, destroy all German vehicles of the time. Despite its shortcomings, the Firefly is still regarded as one of the best Allied tanks of the war, and arguably the best AT tank going. If you have enjoyed the video, please subscribe and support the channel for more. Many thanks for watching.